Hi guys, this is Ranger Rob, and welcome to the Ranger Rob Country Living Channel. Beautiful day today, and I'm on a mission. I've got tons of radishes that I really like to pull and get them cleaned up. And I've refrigerated radishes before, and the way you do it is you clean them. And then put them in a bag with paper towels and try not, get the moisture off them. And they last in the refrigerator quite a while. Anyway, my radishes are, there's three buckets underneath the towers here, and they're all looking quite large. And I don't want to let them sit under here too long. So let's pick some radishes and see how we do. Got a white one. So just one bucket alone, got some pretty good sized radishes. I did have some smaller ones too, but yeah, I think I'm going to keep pulling them. Oh my gosh, look at the size of that. Well, this should be an interesting day because you guys know all that corn I got that's went pfft. Anyway, I got contacted by a local person named Sharon Malone, and I think we've met before, and she's got horses, and she says her horses would love to have that corn, those corn stalks they eat. And I was like, well, I'd love to see them used for if they're good nutrition and the horses enjoy them. Oh, heck yeah. So they're on their way over here, and I don't know how she likes to be recorded or not, but we'll see. And we're just gonna cut stalks and throw them in the back of her truck so she can feed the horses, and I'm happy to feed the horses. So good trade-off. I need to cut them down anyway, and they're still green, so they should be really good for the horses. So we'll see how that goes. So hopefully I'll be able to record a little bit of it. All right, guys, so it's been a little later and Sharon Malone is here. Turns out we knew each other from years ago and have a lot of same acquaintances. And this is really good because she's gonna take as much as she wants of this corn, and you're gonna feed them to horses, right?
Horse.
A horse. And you got a horse that you adopted.
Yes.
So
from anyway. Mustangs to the rescue.
That's our highest priority, is to see to it that this stuff doesn't go to waste. Mm-hmm. And knowing it's going to an adopted horse that you actually fostered first is exciting for us. So we're really happy to cut these down. We'll load them in her truck over here. And after we're done here, we'll kind of show you the results. And really a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And she watches our videos. So... I don't know if she's very impressed, but was really happy to have her here. So anyway, we're gonna get started. We got some work to do. All right, guys, so we got Sharon's truck filled up with quite a bit of corn, and we still got a lot more. And I told her we're gonna take her time taking it down. We'll feed the horse weekly or whatever she wants to do, and because we're in no hurry, we got all winter to get this cleared out. So I'm really happy we were able to do that for the horse.
And I wanted to add that I'm not going to give, don't anybody yell at me, I'm not going to give the corn stalks, just throw them out in the fence for the horse, one or two a day in the winter time as a treat.
Yeah.
I do know about horses. I won't kill my horse, honest.
Yeah, and that's why we're only doing a little bit at a time. And so I've told her she has all the time in the world, and we'll do it very slowly and spoil that horse. as long as we can spoil her. So yeah, that's a good deal. Well guys, that was a lot of fun meeting Sharon. She moved on the ranch here around 1993. I moved here in 1999 for a period of time. So many things that were unique back in those days that we ended up probably talking way more than getting any work done. So Sharon, if you're watching this, sorry if I kept you too much, but it's so fun to talk to people that know the history of this place. This place is called Crooked River Ranch. And so there's a lot of stories to share with folks who have been here for a while. So I hope the horse enjoys that. She sounds like she's very responsible. And we're just going to cut that down at the speed that she needs it. And so, because we're in no hurry to get that. I mean, I got all winter to get that cut down. But I'm glad we're cutting them down while they're kind of green, when they're a little bit more nutritional. So, yeah, that's kind of a neat thing to do here. And if she doesn't take it all, no harm done. So, yeah, she's doing us a favor and we're doing the horse a favor. And so, yeah, guys, just nice to meet people. Good to get out, meet people from the community. Turns out we, in a sense, knew each other, and we probably met each other a few times and we just didn't really realize it. So, yeah. Well, guys, we decided this was some of the corn that we did get out of our, like, I got 6 ears of corn that were almost edible, but we decided to give these to the chickens. Chickens love to pick the corn off of these. They don't eat the whole thing, and it'll be a nice treat for them. So we're heading out to the chicken hutch right now, and it's so weird to see my corn all torn up. Anyway, we're gonna throw this in the pen and let them have some fun. Hello, girls. You guys want some corn? I was also lucky enough to have Sharon take home some Swiss chard. Some reason she didn't want the giant ones. But she took one home, and that helps us out. I need to thin out the NFT system a little bit. Thought we'd stop in at the greenhouse real quick, let everybody have a look. Everything's looking really good in here. About 84 degrees. And the interesting thing is, look at this. I've got green beans again. I didn't expect that. Definitely still got tomatoes, but they're not ripening as fast as they did before because it's definitely cooler at night. And the lettuce is going super well. But this is what I'm really excited about, is the bok choy. Look at this. So once again, I'm having, the only time I've ever had bok choy was they put like a piece in maybe a Chinese soup and noodle kind of thing. And I like that, but I'm really excited to start figuring out how I'm gonna cook these. I think by this weekend, I think we're gonna go ahead and harvest some of this, if not all of it, and see how we like it. I can't wait to try it. So, one of the things that Sharon, the guy was here earlier, I was talking about is, you know, we're talking about the history of where we live and how it's changed a little bit. And one of the things we used to do a lot back over 20 years ago is bartering and sharing and trading with one another, with people on a ranch, for whether it's services or food, things like that, because that was, we're talking about the surplus of food we get here. We want to make sure it gets to people that really appreciate it or will use it. So we try to practice what we preach here. So that's the kind of thing that really ties into a lot of things we're talking about in the future. If times get tough or we all get lockdowns or we have some economy problems, where trading is going to be important. So if you don't have a physical, if you have a physical skill, or you got a items that you have in your property that you're growing and stuff, you may find it's something you could trade for us to have somebody help us once in a while on the property. Let's put it this way, I'll fill their tummies up with a lot of food. And plus we have other things we can barter. And of course you've heard me talk about buying silver or gold once in a while. And that's always a good thing to trade too. So anyway, just walking up here. Dogs are barking. We got a dog that's across on the other side of the fence that Belle likes to bark at. So, and they run against the fence like greyhounds. So it's kind of good exercise. Kind of funny. But anyway, Sharon, yes, I appreciate the good old days. And there's still a spirit of that trading, bartering, helping one another on this area that we live in. And I hope it stays that way, if not get better. Because there's a whole new generation living here now. And they're just discovering that kind of stuff, where it's something that was kind of natural to us. Well, guys, it's been a really nice day. Got to meet some nice people. And, but I gotta mention one of my videos where we're talking about complying. And it was interesting, even in my local area, a debate was going on about people with or without a jab. And it's kind of two areas I also kind of like to remind people of is freedom and liberty means tolerance. So just like I've got 5 acres here and there's another 5 acres next to me that somebody else owns. And they may do a few things that I may not like, maybe have a couple of extra cars or something or RV in their property. And if they're not breaking the law and or ordinances, I need to tolerate that. Same thing goes with this discussion I'm seeing in one of the Facebook things. Somebody all out says somebody doesn't have a jab, they should be shot, or they should be secluded in some desert island or something. And I was like, well, wait a minute. Those that have the jab are also transmitting what they're getting the jab for. Do they have to move to that same island? It's like, it comes down to, guys, do what's best for you. And whether you get it or not, it doesn't affect me at all. I'm protected or not. I could still get it. So, where does that justify segregating people? Last time I heard of that happened in the 1940s. Saying different people, races, beliefs, or whatever are not acceptable anymore. And that's a really bad road to go down. And I always thought some of us learned from history, but apparently not. So I just urge people to respect freedom and liberty. Respect the fact that people have concerns whether or not they get a jab or not. And there's a lot of reasons why they don't. And so we need to understand that. And there's lots of other circumstances. Some people have a lot of elements where if they take the jab, it could actually cause them more problems. And then there's people who already got COVID, and there's science papers out there saying that's stronger and better than getting the jab. So I just urge everybody to make sure and continue watching the reports and understand we all need to be careful whether we have a jab or not. to wear masks at an appropriate time, and try not to be in crowds too much, and use a little bit of, I'm going to use a word that might really shock, especially that one who wants to shoot everybody, common sense. Be accountable for yourself, and whether you got the jab or not, you're not a public risk. Probably could hurt yourself more than anybody else, because the people with a jab are equivalent to you as far as giving it to other folks. So unless I see other science, but that's what's coming out right now. So I rest my case there for now. If you can convince me otherwise in a civil way, that's the funny part. I can't seem to see the opposing folks are not civil. They're just attack, don't account for anything else. And that's sad. So, but anyway, with that note, I just wanted to respond that way. I respect both sides of the fence on that. But come on, guys. There's reasons, there's facts, there's issues, there's all kinds of reasons whether someone gets a jab or not. And let's just try to remember that. So anyway, guys, with that note, I hope everybody has a great day. I want to thank you very much for watching. Please take the time to like, subscribe, and share our videos all over the whole wide world. We'd really appreciate that. And guys, have a wonderful day. Bye now.
Our videos are made possible by Ranger Rob Poopy Bags, available at Amazon right now.
Thank you very much for watching our video. Please take the time to like, subscribe, and share our videos all over the whole wide world. Thanks.